Okay. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار، أعادني الله وإياكم منها. After that, إخواني, at a short notice, I was requested to talk about the Day of Judgment. So inshallah, I will speak of that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes easy for me. رَبِّ اشْرَحْ لِي صَدْرِي وَيَسِّرْ لِي أَمْرِي وَأَحْلُلْ عُقَدَةً مِّن لِسَانِي يَفْقَهُ قَوْلِي. I start from inshallah, or the talk inshallah today will be about 3 points of يوم القيامة. The Hashr, which is the gathering, and where the Hashr will take place, and the third, which will be the way that people are going to be this day. The topic of Iman bil Yawm al-Akhirah is a big topic, no doubt. It's the Iman. The Iman is based on to believe in the Day of Judgment. The Hadith of Jibreel, بَيْنَمَا نَحْنُ جُلُوسٌ عِنْدَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ ذَاتَ يَوْمٍ إِذْ طَلَعَ عَلَيْنَا رَجُلٌ شَدِيدُ بَيَاضِ الثِّيَابِ شَدِيدُ سَوَادِ الشَّعْرِ لَا يُرَى عَلَيْهِ أَثَرُ السَّفَرِ وَلَا يَعْرِفُهُ مِنَّا أَحَدٌ حَتَّى جَلَسَ إِلَى النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ فأسند ركبتيه إلى ركبتيه ووضع كفيه على فخذيه وقال يا محمد أخبرني عن الإسلام. And the Prophet told him about Islam. Then he said, يا محمد أخبرني عن الإيمان. Tell me what إيمان is. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إيمان is أن تؤمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله واليوم الآخر وتؤمن بالقدر خيره وشره. So the belief, or the 6 pillars of Iman, is to believe in the Day of Judgment. One's Iman is not full, or he hasn't got a full Iman, if he doesn't believe in the Day of Judgment. The non-believers, the people who don't have Iman, Allah said, speaking about them, زَعَمَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَلَّا يُبْعَثُوا قُلْ بَلَا وَرَبِّي لَتُبْعَثُنَّ ثُمَّ لَتُنَبَّأُنَّ بِمَا عَمِلْتُمْ وَذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ يَسِيرٌ. The non-believers, they say, we're not going to be resurrected. Allah said, O Muhammad, say to them, Wallahi, you will be resurrected and you will be told of what you have done in this dunya. So the Day of Judgment is haqq. We're going to see it. It's going to come. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَفَحَسِبْتُمْ أَنَّمَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ عَبَثًا وَأَنَّكُمْ إِلَيْنَا لَا تُرْجَعُونَ. Have you thought or assumed أَنَّمَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ, that we have created you without no purpose or aim. We've created you for a joke. وَأَنَّكُمْ إِلَيْنَا لَا تُرْجَعُونَ, and that you will not come back to us. Is that what you have thought? That's a rhetorical question. Meaning, wallahi, you will come back to us. And na'am, wallahi, we will inform you of that which you have done in the dunya. Now, if that's the case, the topic unfolds itself here, inshallah. What does Hashr mean? In Arabic, it means جَمْعُ الْخَلَائِقِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَابَةِ لِحِسَابِهِمْ وَالْقَضَاءِ بَيْنَهُمْ. The Hashr means gathering the creation in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be questioned and to be judged in between that which they did to themselves and that which they did to their own selves. That's what Hashr means. Allah says in the Quran, وأنذر به أو محمد warn them like the people الذين those يخافونه fear and يحشروا to be resurrected إلى ربهم to their Lord. So they have fear in them that they're going to be resurrected in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now when somebody fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is not كلمة يتردد فيه الألسن. It is not كلام and speech he just says all the time, I fear Allah. Rather, his actions show that he fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You see when he speaks, his words consists of trustworthy. He doesn't lie. If he makes an appointment, he doesn't break the promise that he made with the people. He is a person who has good character, who is a person who takes Islam from all of its corners. He doesn't take some and leave some. أَفَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِبَعْضِ الْكِتَابِ وَتَكْفُرُونَ بِبَعْضِ. Are you going to believe in some of the Quran and choose to take whatever you like and leave what you don't like? No, their fear leads to them to act. Aisha رضي الله عنها, may Allah have mercy upon her. When the verse Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْتُونَ مَا أَتَوْا وَقُلُوبُهُمْ وَجِلَةٌ أَنَّهُمْ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ رَاجِعُونَ. They do what they do, but then in their heart is fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Aisha said, Ya Rasulullah, أَهُمُ الَّذِينَ يَزْنُونَ. Are they those who commit adultery, who fornicate, who lie, who do trickery? Rasulullah said, لا. They are the people who fast, who pray, who come with righteous actions, and they fear that Allah might not accept it from them. So even that of the person might come with actions, he still hopes that Allah accepts it from him. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in an authentic hadith, لا أحد يدخل الجنة بعمله. Nobody enters Jannah with his action. No, you will not enter Jannah because of an action you have done. And the companion said, وَلَا أَنْتَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, even you. He said, وَلَا أَنَا, even me. إِلَّا أَنْ يَتَغَمَّدَنِيَ اللَّهُ بِرَحْمَةٍ وَفَضْلٍ مِنْهُ. Only for Allah to have mercy upon me is what's going to take me to Jannah. I cannot force my way through to Jannah, the Prophet is saying. If Allah hasn't got no mercy on me, then no, I will not enter Jannah of my action. The people who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, their actions show. So it's not just speech. He is a Muslim every single minute and second. Allah said, لَيْسَ لَهُمْ, that day they do not have, مِنْ دُونِهِ, besides Allah, they do not have, وَلِيٌّ, a helper, وَلَا شَفِيعٌ, and a protector. That day, there is no helper other than Allah. Every person is scared for himself. وَكُلَّ إِنسَانٍ أَلْزَمْنَاهُ طَائِرَهُ فِي عُنُقِهِ ونخرج له يوم القيامة كتابا يلقاه منشورا. That day, your affairs are too much for you. يوم يفر المرء من أخيه وأمه وأبيه وصاحبته وبنيه لكل امرئ منهم يومئذ شأن يغنيه. Your soul or yourself, your life is more than enough for you. Ponder with me, brothers and sisters. Imagine, or look at it in this way, who is better than Nabiullah Nuh? Who is better than Ibrahim? Allah said, speaking about Ibrahim, وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِ غَيْرَ وَمَنْ يَرْغَبُ عَنْ مِلَّةِ إِبْرَاهِيمَ إِلَّا مَنْ سَفِهَ نَفْسَهُ وَلَقَدِ اسْتَفَيْنَاهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَإِنَّهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ لَمِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. Nobody turned away from the path of Ibrahim. His religion was a religion that was away from worshipping other than Allah. It was a religion based on monotheism. Allah said, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ دِينًا, which religion is better than the religion of Ibrahim? He submitted himself to Allah. وَاتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ إِبْرَاهِيمَ خَلِيلًا, and Allah made Ibrahim his friend, a close friend. Ibrahim يوم القيامة, and Nuh عليه السلام, who are the أولو العزم من الرسول, and Isa عليه السلام, and Musa, that day will say, nafsi, nafsi, myself, myself, I can't help you. The Prophet said to his daughter Aisha, Fatima bint Rasulillah, he said to Fatima, silni ma bada laka min mali, ask me for whatever you want for my wealth, ask me now in this dunya. If you want money, I'll give it to you. Wala ugni anka min Allahi shay'a, as for yawmul qiyamah, I cannot help you a little bit. I am not able to help you and take you away She's going to the hellfire. Because of that day, the hole and the shiddah, the people have no ability. So there is no helper and there's no protector other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now the believer who has real iman in his heart, when he hears these kind of verses, what happens to him? He starts to become concerned of himself. A day where he can't even help his own self. وَيَوْمَ نُسَيِّرُ الْجِبَالَ وَتَرَى الْأَرْضَ بَارِزَةً وَحَشَرْنَاهُمْ فَلَمْ نُغَادِرْ مِنْهُمْ أَحَدًا وَعُرِضُوا عَلَى رَبِّكَ صَفًّا لَقَدْ جِئْتُمُونَا كَمَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ أَوَّلَ مَرَّةٍ بَلْ زَعَمْتُمْ أَن لَّن نَّجْعَلَ لَكُم مَّوْعِدًا وَوُضِعَ الْكِتَابُ فَتَرَى الْمُجْرِمِينَ مُشْفِقِينَ مِمَّا فِيهِ وَيَقُولُونَ يَا وَيْلَتَنَا مَا لِهَذَا الْكِتَابِ لَا يُغَادِرُ صَغِيرَةً وَلَا كَبِيرَةً إِلَّا أَحْصَاهَا وَوَجَدُوا مَا عَمِلُوا حَاضِرًا وَلَا يَظْلِمْ رَبُّكَ أَحَدًا. Nobody needs to talk to you. Nobody needs to tell you anything. Your book is going to tell you what you've committed. It's enough for you. This is, it has everything. مَا يَلْفِذُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَدَيْهِ رَقِيبٌ عَتِيدٌ. He never uttered a word. He never said anything. Only that it was written. Ata, Mujahid, Tawus, Mujahid ibn Jabra and Abdullah ibn Abbas, they said even the good that you write, the good that you do and the bad that you do, the angels write everything. Action and words that you say. They don't leave anything. They write everything you have committed or have done. If it's good, the ones on the right write it. If you do sin, the left one writes it. إِنَّ الْعَبْدَ لَيَتَكَلَّمُ بِكَلِمَةٍ. The servant speaks in a speech. It's Sahih al-Bukhari. In Hadith Abu Huraira, the Prophet said, إِنَّ الْعَبْدَ لَيَتَكَلَّمُ بِكَلِمَةٍ. The person will speak a speech. لَا يُلْقِي لَهَا بَالًا. To him, it doesn't weigh anything. It's just a normal thing. He's cracking a joke in front of his friend. He doesn't weigh what he's going to say. He doesn't look at it. He doesn't put it on a scale. He just says it. لَا يُلْقِي لَهَا بَالًا. يَهْوِي فِي نَارِ جَهَنَّمْ. He dips down deep into Jahannam because of a word he spoke. So the person consistently, Ata ibn Abi Rabah from the Tabi'in, and he was Abdullah ibn Abbas' student, and he was one of the Kibar Tabi'in, he, may Allah have mercy upon him, said, Wallahi ma qultu qawlan. I never spoke a speech, only that I questioned myself 70 times, shall I say this? Those are people who have fear, wallahi they do. They speak with conscience. They act with conscience. Because why? They believe in this day and they were getting prepared for this day. The Sahabas, they used to make a grave in front of their houses, in their own houses in front of it, or inside their houses, and they will go inside their grave and they will stay there for hours and cry and cry, and they will say, لعلي ارجعني لعلي أعمل صالحا فيما تركت, which is the day everybody's going to say, oh Allah, take me back to the dunya so I can do one good. Then he comes back, he says to himself, Allah is now giving you the chance to go back to the dunya. Work for it. You have the opportunity. They used to make themselves ready for this day, mentally, physically, in every way. They were ready for this day. Are we really ready if we passed out today? For that day, يوم القيامة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَيَوْمَ يُحْشَرُهُمْ. The day Allah gathers the people, everybody. The kings, the rulers, everybody. Nobody's better than nobody that day. Everybody's going to be standing amam Allah Ta'ala. Hufatan, uratan, ghullan. He's going to be standing in front of Allah, naked, uncircumcised, no shoes on. Kings, whoever you are, you'll be like that. Everybody's going to be naked. Even the prophets will be naked. Ikhwani, isn't that shiddah? There's a narration, وَفِيهِ مَقَالٍ. In it is كلام, which is not authenticity, is not high. But بعض العلماء, they say, يرتقى إلى الحسن بمجمع طرقها. When the hadith comes together, it reaches the status of Hassan. Of Allah knows more. But the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, Abu Bakr was sitting in with one day, and he looked at the Prophet's beard, and he said, أراك قد شفت يا رسول الله. Oh, the Prophet of Allah, I see inside your beard, now you have become old. White hair was going inside the Prophet's beard here and there. He said, يا رسول الله, I can see you're turning old. And the Prophet said, شَيَّبَتْنِي هُودٌ وَأَخْوَاتُهَا. Surah Hud and its brothers is what made my beard become white. Because of what it talks about.